And now we're sitting here with Judy Reyes, who plays the mom in Gun Hill Road. Welcome, Judy.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm well.
We're just a little famished this morning. Everything's going faster than I ever dreamed it would.
And
I didn't get to read the production notes. And so you're going to have to like fill me in on everything.
I'll fill you in on whatever you need.
Yes, okay. Well, I've known Rashad for like 10 years.
Have you? Yeah. How's that?
From NYU.
Oh, really?
From NYU grad acting, and I saw all of his amazing performances there, and then he went on to...
direct. Who knew?
Who knew? Mm-hmm. Who knew? Did you go to NYU too?
I did not.
No. Okay, so how did you and Rashad connect?
I got his script. They sent me his script in Los Angeles with the offer for this fantastic film called Gun Hill Road, and I read it, and I said, oh my God, how is it that this thing came to me? And I knew I had to do it. And so we had a conversation, and then we had a meeting, and we hooked up, and the rest is history.
So there you were out in Los Angeles. Was he in Los Angeles too?
No, he was not.
He actually came to New York
and we met, and we discussed the film.
Because I have to tell our viewers, you're so young and so beautiful and so cute. I mean, I didn't recognize you when you walked in the door from your performance in the film as the mother. I thought it was a much, much older actress, but... Mm-hmm. So you transformed, honey.
I did. You were the weight of years of angst, of transformation, of having a husband in prison, and a child who is
going
transgendering.
Through yes.
And going through...
Which was my story, too, in the Bronx. I don't know why I'm not in this movie.
Really?
Yes! I was going through the same thing in the Bronx, but not at the same time.
Ah.
Yeah,
Where did you grow up?
Park Chester.
Oh. Really?
So that was a whole different ethnic thing, but it was a very rigid Catholic family background and very strict, and you know, this was just all totally, well, never mind transgendering, but you know, as you put it, homosexuality was just completely, you know, verboten, as it were. Yeah.
I dig it.
So I felt very strongly about this film, which is why we're here at this hour of the morning.
I'm so glad.
I thought it was really beautiful, as you did, you know, and I mean, everything you said, I totally agree with. Mm-hmm. I got it. I was very moved. It haunts you. I'm thinking about it all the time. And
the arcs of all the characters are so
Let's mention powerful. Your husband's name. He's played
Isai Morales.
I know. Whoa. Playing
the very sexy Isai Morales.
The awesome Hispanic actor who is... in jail, I think, at the beginning of the movie.
At the beginning of the film, he's in jail, and he's just coming out of jail and back to his old haunt of, you know, Gun Hill Road in the Bronx, which, you know, you leave a supposedly rehabilitative environment of prison to your old block, Gun Hill Road, which supposedly, you know, never changes. To your old home. He's just coming.
When I was growing up there, it was not like this.
Well, yeah, exactly.
It's like
yeah.
it is today.
You know, it's like, you know, you go back to the block, you go back to the fellas, everything, you know, that's supposed to be the same. And it's just not. And it's just shocking to his system. And more shocking than anything, his little boy was 13. And he's now 16. And it's just...
And he wants to be a woman.
And
he's becoming one.
And he's becoming one.
As the film goes
on.
And you're the sort of moral compass, the center, like with my mother, she sided with me.
Mm-hmm.
And my father, as in this movie, just couldn't handle it. Mm-hmm. Could not handle it at all. Just like Isai.
Who resisted.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, who fought.
Always. Always.
Fighting
you know.
The current.
But the mother,
time.
My mother, God rest her soul, you know, was like a lot like your character, who was just fighting for her
baby.
Yeah. Was that the only child that you had in the movie?
That's the only child. I
had
in the
movie. Yeah.
Because that focus. Well, the thing that helped, I think, that moved me with when I think with reading the script, I just had my baby.
Oh.
My baby was, I think, 6 or 7 months. So I instantly connected to that feeling, and just reading it was so moving to me. That thing was like, nothing can tear me from this child. Nothing can happen.
Wow.
When nothing can happen that will keep me from this child, that will keep me from doing everything I can to help me do anything I can to protect this child. So that was one thing that I knew. And then I put myself in the position of, what if my child, my little girl, knows that she's a man? And I know my little girl, I put her in dresses, you know? And can I understand
that? That's what Cher did too.
Can I understand that kind of deep psychological hurt in a being that knows that she's not what she is in her mind and looks in the mirror and her mind doesn't match what her body is? I can't understand that, but it is not my job to understand that. It's my job to love her, no matter what. But and when the movie begins, I'm already in that place.
Yeah, you are.
But my husband is not in that place.
Right.
So my job in that movie, I know, is that, and this, so I'm telling about my journey, and which is really fucking hard. Can I say fucking
hard? It's cable. Yeah, same. As much as you like, darling.
It's really fucking hard, you know, because I just have to, like, you know, create the space for him to just, he has to figure it out.
Yeah, you're making me think of what my mother must have been going through,
mm-hmm.
and sticking up for me,
mm-hmm.
you know, against my father's
mm-hmm.
wrath, like in the
yeah.
movie, you know, and outrage and shock and horror and just what that does to
mm-hmm.
people who were brought up a certain way, which of course your family in the film
mm-hmm.
is also Catholic, like mine
yeah.
was, you know, and there's a certain way, you know.
Irish Catholic,
yes, you know, Hispanic,
mm-hmm.
whatever,
mm-hmm.
you know, the church tells you to do certain things
mm-hmm.
a certain way. You know, you're going to get up, and you know, grow up, and you're going to get married
mm-hmm.
and all that stuff. And, you know, I obviously was not. And I didn't know. I didn't know. And I think my mother also went through large denial, too.
Mm-hmm.
But it must have been, I think it was as much of a lifelong struggle for her as it was for me,
mm-hmm.
you know, to accept this. And you're so young and beautiful to be playing a woman who is much older than yourself. Did that daunt you at all?
No, well, I'm 43.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
I'm so wide. But anyway, you're so young today. Flattering.
I think it's the wine. It reflects.
Yeah,
it's the bounce.
Yeah, well, yeah, I'm bouncing orange today. Orange, yeah, yes. So it was, what, a performance though, because you made me totally think you were...
Mm-hmm.
Well,
thank you.
Completely. I mean, I didn't recognize you when you came in.
Well, thank you. Thank you.
Well, is this the producer? Who is this? But, so when did you shoot this? Was that
Oh, God, it's like, what is this, a year ago now, in August?
That's
yeah.
so long ago.
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty fast
yeah.
for an independent mm-hmm. film. And this is
we
a
did
low
it in, like,
budget 20 indie.
20 days, like ultra low budget, yeah. Yeah. And it was a really tough shoot, you know.
You were on location, I guess, in the Bronx
yeah,
the whole time.
The
did
whole
you do
time.
Anything in the studio at all?
No.
Nothing in the
no.
studio. Everything
no.
was on location.
Everything was on location.
There was a lot of rooftop shots.
Down.
Now I know why, because they were great. I said, gee, that roof isn't there. This roof in the Bronx, you know, knowing the Bronx as I do. That's, being a twin, is your sister in show business?
She is. She's.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
I didn't
she
know.
Does pretty well. She was also, I mean, she became a social worker. She's got a master's in social work, and she does that too. But she's a pretty successful actress. She's in the Labyrinth Theater Company along with myself.
Oh, I know them
we're both
very
part
well.
Of
I look
Theater
like Philip's twin, you know. Hello.
You do.
Somebody's writing a movie
See?
Where they're putting me in.
We're both
somebody
twins.
Who is who's gonna get. Yeah. Who's constantly mistaken for Philip Seymour Hoffman. Let's see if it turns out, and evidently my line in the film is...
The gay Philip Seymour.
Yeah, I go, I'm not him, watch my show. That's my line in the movie, if this ever gets right. I was promised this role, who knows?
Were you a Capote?
I am. I mean, I it was very difficult for me to watch that film, believe me, because I thought I should be playing this role. He's not doing it right. He's far too butch. For Truman, oh my God. No, I get mistaken for Truman, and he's dead! So Philip, at least, is still with us,
exactly.
You know. And what a fabulous company that
yes.
is, the Labyrinth Theater.
Wonderful.
Are you involved with them also?
Yes.
Because
they
just...
From the very beginning for like
oh,
the last 18
good
years.
Oh, you. Know, I
must not
have
as,
seen
I'm not,
you
I'm
in
not,
something.
I'm not as active with them as my sister is, but yes. Because,
I mean, the plays that Philip Bailey Gurdjieff's mm-hmm. you know, who just
Stephen
Affleck, thank you. Philip Adley Hoffman. Yes, I did. Motherfucker with it. I had them all on. Yeah, yeah.
Wasn't
incredible, incredible. And I don't live in the Bronx anymore, but I live in the building that mm-hmm. the play is set in. So anyway, it's come full circle with Stephen Adley Gurgis.
Yes.
So he goes, I can't get over how much you look like Philip. He kept saying that. Anyway, Judy Reyes, thank you so much
thank
for
you.
Taking the time today.
It's a pleasure. Thank
dropping
you so
by, as it were, on the Stephen Holt Show, the movie is Gun Hill Road. Fantástico, señorita.
Gracias.
Okay. Gracias
a ti.